Hello students, this is Santrupt here. We are doing a NADA program of NADA laboratory, program number 3B. And the program says you have to suppose to create three threads. So that is what the main thing is all about. You have to create a threads. So mainly we are using multi-threads. So this program says how to implement the multi-thread to provide multitasking. So that is what the agenda of this particular program is all about. What this program does is you are supposed to create three threads. So thread T1, thread T2, and then thread T3. So first thread, what it does is it creates a random number. So any random number it can be. So any random numbers will be created by thread 1. So thread 2 will create the square of this particular random number. And then thread 3 is supposed to create the cube of this particular random number. So that is what you are supposed to do. This is what the agenda or the problem statement which you are supposed to do it. So basically we are implementing the multi-thread to provide or to show the multitasking ability. So for that to happen, you can see here in the main function, the first thread will be created and the thread name is T1. So thread will be doing what here? It is calling a random thread. So what is that random thread? I already told you, you have to generate a random number. So any thread in your Java is being created with the help of extending a particular class or by implementing a class called as, it implements runnable. So runnable is a particular class which is been implemented, and that says you have been creating a thread. So you can see here runnable implements the runnable. So that is what is happening for doing this. You see, T1 is here creating a random thread, T2 is here creating a square, and then T3 is here which is creating a cube. So basically what happens is when you are calling a random number, the t1.start is the initialization or the creation of a first thread here. So first thread is been created here. So when first thread is been called, for first thread is for what? Randomizing the number. So it comes here. So when you are randomizing, you are also creating another threads, that is t2 and then t3 here. T2 and then t3 is been created. Okay. Now when you are doing it, what the thread is supposed to do is being said by a run function or a run for a particular function. So in run function, what you are doing, you are creating a random number. So this particular thread has to create a random number. It has to sleep for 1 second. And then again, it has to create a random number, and the process keeps on continuing. So that is why we have been using the particular option of sleep here. Sleep 1000 is because it is in the millisecond. So if you convert that, it will be in 1 second. So every thread has to create a number, random number, and the square of that should be calculated, cube of that should be calculated, sleep for 1 second, and again the process keeps on continuing. So that is what will be implemented here. You can see here random numbers is being generated at this location. So once the random number has been generated, then you have been calling the square of that number, then you are calling the cube of that number, and then calling the square, you have been starting it, calling the cube, you have been starting it. So then you have been going for sleeping 1 second, then again you have been running back the statement again. So this is what you have been doing it. So we'll see here, the square, again I told you, any thread what to be done will be told by a run. See here also you have a run. See here also you have a run. So thread 1 will creating a random number. So this is what the thread 1 is been saying here, random. So thread 2 will be told that you have to create a square of a number. So you can see here square formula is been done, and then thread 3 is been done for cube of a number. So basically what is happening, any random number, say 2 is been generated, the square of that will be generated by thread 2 and the cube of that will be generated by thread 3. So the answer would be something like this. That is, it is 2, 4 and then 8. So that is what the answer. Let's see the output later on. Thank you. This is the thread program, and we'll see the output of this by debugging it. So we are doing nothing, we are just running the program, and we can able to see it is generating a random number for every second, and it's creating a square of it and a cube of it. I'll pause and I'll show you. See this, this is the number which has been generated, or any random number, square of that and a cube of this. See here, there are many set of outputs which have been generated. These are the random numbers generated, square of it and a cube of it, 4, 16 and 64, and that's how the